Hey, what's going on guys? Sandeep here, and sometimes you might get this blue screen of death error on your Windows 10 or Windows 11. And the stop code would be critical process died. So in this video, you will find different ways to fix this problem on your Windows PC, whether you are running Windows 10 or Windows 11. There might be two situations. First, if you are able to log in back to your Windows after the blue screen of death. Second, you might not be able to log in back to your Windows and getting this error again and again. Now, if you are able to log in, then stick to the video. Otherwise, you can jump to the given timestamp, and all the time codes are given in video description as well. So if you are logged in, then you can try to uninstall recently installed programs, or you can try to uninstall the graphics driver. Go to settings, then apps option, installed apps, find the recently installed apps and uninstall it. It mainly happens due to graphics card driver, so you have to uninstall it and then reinstall again. It might be NVIDIA, AMD or Intel's HD graphic driver. So you have to uninstall and then restart your PC and check. Now the next thing you can do is boot your PC with essential services only. Press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard to open run dialog box and type there msconfig and press OK. Now go to General tab and choose Selective Startup and then hit Apply and OK. And after that, you have to restart your PC and check for the blue screen of death error. If it is fixed, then good, otherwise follow the next method. In this method, you can try to update your Windows. Go to Menu and Settings, choose for Update and Security. And if there are new updates available, you have to download and install all the updates. And after that, restart your PC. This might fix the problem. If not, follow the next method. In this method, you can try to fix the disk errors and repair the corrupt files. Go to search and search for CMD and open it as admin. Click on the yes option. Now on the CMD, you have to type certain commands. First, you need to type chkdsk, then space, c colon and press enter. Also, you can run this command chkdsk space c colon space forward slash f. And next command you should run is sfc then space forward slash scan now. It will find and fix the any integrity violation with your Windows files. It might take some time, so you have to wait till the process is complete. The system file checker command will try to find and repair any kind of corrupt file with your Windows. And after that, you have to restart your PC and check. You can also run the DISM commands to repair the corrupt Windows image file and then run the SFC scan, which I will discuss later on in this video. And if this doesn't work, you can try to restore your system to previous date using system restore. Press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard and type there restrui.exe and then press OK. It will open system restore. Click on next option. And there might be some restore point when your computer was working fine. So you have to select that restore point and next, then finish. And after that, it will restart your computer and then restore to that date. And this should fix the problem. If restore is successful, it will fix the problem. Now, if you don't have any restore point or Windows couldn't restore your computer, then you can try to reset your PC. Go to menu, then settings. And update and security option and click on recovery option. Click on get started under reset this PC and select keep my files. You have to select local reinstall. If the local reinstall works, then good. Otherwise, next time you have to select cloud download. So first you have to try with local reinstall and then click on next and click on reset. This will reset your PC. It won't remove any personal files, but it will delete all the apps and programs. So you have to reinstall those programs again after the reset. Now, if you are using Windows 11, then go to menu, then settings. Click on system tab and then recovery option. You will find reset this PC option and you have to reset your PC and follow the same process. Now the second situation is that you are unable to log in to your Windows and keeps getting the blue screen of death error message again and again. So in this case, you have to start your PC in recovery mode. To start your PC in recovery mode, you have to shut down your computer first and then press the power key to restart it. While you see the Windows logo or the manufacturer logo is loading, then press and hold the power key again to shut it down. And you have to repeat this process 3 times. And after that, when you turn on your PC, you will see advanced recovery options like this. Now click on troubleshoot option and then advanced options. You can see that you have option to reset your PC here, but generally it doesn't work if you can't log into your PC. So go to advanced options and then first you have to try with startup repair. This startup repair might fix the problem with your PC, but in most cases the startup repair doesn't work. However, you should try it first. If it doesn't work, go to advanced option again or open the advanced recovery option and go to troubleshoot again, advanced options, and then try to uninstall updates. If you are getting blue screen of death, critical process died after a Windows update, then you should try to uninstall updates. Uninstalling updates might fix the problem. Once you click on uninstall updates, you will get options to uninstall quality updates as well as feature updates. So you have to uninstall both updates one by one. And after that, restart your PC and check if you can log into your Windows or not. If not, follow the next method. Now you have to boot your PC in recovery mode again. Do the shutdown and startup process 3 times and come back to this recovery option. Now go to troubleshoot option again and advanced option. Click on command prompt. On the command prompt, first you have to find which partition contains all the Windows files. It might be C drive, E drive or D drive. So you have to find it first. For that you need to type BCD edit, then press enter on your keyboard. Look for OS device. You will find OS device and the partition. In this case, the partition is C. It might be D, E or any other letter in your case, but you have to remember it. Now you need to execute certain commands on this CMD. First you need to type boot rec then space forward slash fix MBR then press enter on your keyboard. Now the next command you need to type is boot rec then space forward slash fix boot then press enter. If you are getting access is denied error message, then you can ignore it and type the next command, which is boot sect then space forward slash NT60 then space SYS sys then press enter on your keyboard. Now you can see that boot code was successfully updated. Now you can try to fix the boot. Type boot rec then space forward slash fix boot and the command will go through. The operation was completed successfully. Now you need to rebuild the boot configuration data file by typing boot rec then space forward slash rebuild BCD. Then press enter on your keyboard. It might take some time, and if you get total identified Windows installation 0, that means it didn't create boot configuration data file. It will go through on your MBR disk, but it won't work on your GPT disk. If you are running a GPT disk, then command is different. You need to type BCD boot then space the operating system partition, which is C in this case, C:\Windows. You have to replace C with whatever partition contains Windows file, then press enter and it will recreate the boot configuration data file. So if you are running MBR disk, you can try to rebuild BCD using boot rec rebuild BCD or try the second command on your GPT disk. If you are unsure, you can try both commands. It won't harm anything. Now the next command you should type is chkdsk then space operating system drive colon then space forward slash f then press enter on your keyboard. It will check for any disk error and repair them. I will skip the waiting part. Now the next command you need to type is sfc then space forward slash scan now and press enter on your keyboard. The system file checker command will try to find any kind of integrity violation with your Windows files and repair them. So you have to wait till the process is complete. And after that you can exit out CMD and turn off your computer and then restart again. I mean start your PC and check if you can log into your Windows. In most cases, this should fix the blue screen of death problem with your Windows 10 or Windows 11. By any chance, if these things are not working, you can try to boot your PC in safe mode. Your PC might open in safe mode. Go to Troubleshoot option, then Advanced option, and click on Startup Settings, and then restart your PC. Once you restart it, you will get this kind of screen. At this screen, you have to press number 5 to open your PC in safe mode with networking. Press number 5 and it will open your PC in safe mode with networking. In the safe mode, you can try to restore your PC to previous dates as discussed in the first situation. Press Windows plus R to open Run dialog box and type rstrui.exe, then click OK and click on Next and find a restore point when computer was working fine and restore your PC to the previous date. Now the next thing you can do is go to search and search for CMD and run it as admin. First you have to execute SFC command. Type there SFC then space forward slash scan now then press enter and let the process complete. Basically you can do all the things mentioned in the first situation once you are logged in into the safe mode. If the SFC command doesn't work, you can try DISM command. Open CMD as admin and type DISM then space forward slash online then space forward slash cleanup hyphen image then space forward slash check health and press enter on your keyboard. Next command you need to type is same DISM command but in the last you have to type scan health then press enter on your keyboard. It will take some time to find any kind of corruption with the Windows image file into your PC. And the last command is similar but you have to replace scan health with restore health. Then press enter on your keyboard. It will repair the Windows image file. It will repair the health of Windows image file. It might take some time. Once the process is complete, it is necessary to run the SFC command again, so that Windows can repair the corrupt file using the repaired version of Windows image file. So you need to run the SFC command after running the DISM commands. Type SFC then space forward slash scan now and then let the process complete. And once the process is complete, you need to exit out CMD and restart your PC in normal mode. And after the restart, you would be able to log into your Windows 10 or Windows 11. So this is how you can fix critical process died blue screen of death on your Windows 10 or Windows 11. And that's all for this video guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos and I will see you in my next one.